Item number, SCP-270. Object class, Euclid. Special containment procedures. Due to SCP-270's immovable nature, a structure has been built around it that outwardly appears to be a large farmhouse, henceforth called Outpost Delta. Outpost Delta is to be staffed with trained personnel. Extensive records of SCP-270's ciphers are kept at Site 11. If the security of Outpost Delta is compromised, SCP-270 is to be destroyed, along with all on-base records of verified or unverified information accumulated, and manuscripts outlining various encryptions SCP-270 has used. Description: SCP-270 is a nondescript black phone of mid-20th century make. There were no human populations at the location of discovery, and SCP-270 itself was well hidden by surrounding native vegetation. The unusual properties of SCP-270 were apparent upon discovering that the power cord extended an indefinite length into the soil directly below SCP-270, despite which a steady voice was speaking through the earphone. Investigations regarding how long the cord is have since been officially discontinued. What makes SCP-270 of continued interest is the audio stream from the earphone, which has since been discovered to contain encrypted messages that are of value to the Foundation. Said ciphers are referred to as SCP-271. For the most part, SCP-271 consists of a mildly distorted human voice speaking in a steady monotone, which has been recorded listing names, cryptic phrases, patterns of numbers, quotes, mangled quotes, strings of letters, data expunged, incomprehensible words, sounds that cannot be produced by any known animal that continue for extended amounts of time, monologues, nursery rhymes, leading to speculation as to whether or not the narrator is in fact human, etc. The following has also been recorded: melodies, metallic scraping noises, metallic scraping noises that have been looped and recalibrated so they play roughly in the same tune as several classical music tunes, and a handful of data expunged, Morse code, human screaming, various computer programming languages, every known language on Earth, including in one incident, Pig Latin, data expunged, possibly of biological origin, condescending laughter, music, music played backwards, conversations that have evidently been recorded ranging from politically significant and extensively protected area to what was most likely an average household, discussing what grocery supplies to buy from the supermarket, static, ambient soundtracks, etc. Following is an approximate 1 minute long demonstrative sample of SCP-271. SCP-270 is otherwise a perfectly normal phone, and is susceptible to damage, as similar phones would be. Disassembly has not uncovered the source of SCP-270's unusual properties. Attempts to decipher SCP-271 have yielded partial successes. In one notable case, a complicated cipher proved to be an intensive description of an SCP's imminent attempt to breach containment. Containment breach was accordingly prevented. Decoded portions have alternately been startlingly useful to the Foundation, and immensely frustrating to both personnel working on SCP-271 and Foundation officials. For example, one several-hour study of what seemed to be a significant cipher proved to translate into a long and painstakingly thorough list of extremely unofficial synonyms for a human, data expunged. Likewise, information gained from SCP-271 has both prevented a possible XK-class end-of-the-world scenario, and listed secret ingredients of Dr. R's widely praised cherry pie. As it is impossible to determine how useful portions of SCP-271 will be, personnel are advised to choose whatever segment of SCP-271 they deem to be most promising. However, some portions of Cipher are either too intricately encrypted for our most perspicacious personnel to decode, or indeed may hold no meaning at all. Attempts to decode SCP-271 are continually ongoing. Addendum 270A. A probe was extended a total of meters along the wire before the maximum extension length was reached. The matter has since been declared not of sufficient interest to merit a more thorough examination. Addendum 270B. As of the unidentified female voice of SCP-271 stuttered for several seconds before breaking down into what researchers described as disconsolate sobs, pleading to be data expunged. This continued for several more seconds before audio cut off abruptly to an excerpt of SCP-271. Immediately afterwards, SCP-271 proceeded as usual, the only noticeable difference being that the voice narrating SCP-271 was male. Addendum 270C. Further examinations reveal that this was in fact not silence, but audio stimuli both too high or too low pitched for human perception. Numerous additional unidentified languages have been discovered upon supplying Outpost Delta with appropriate audio equipment. Addendum 270D. As of late, SCP-271 has been becoming noticeably more difficult to decode. This includes utilizing more convoluted methods of encryption, loud background noises being added while the narrator is speaking, multiple voices speaking at once, and, in one case, loud, extremely personal details about Dr. A, who was visibly shaken by the event. Morale has since plummeted, while stress levels have skyrocketed. A computer program has been coded in order to automatically decode portions of SCP-271. A recreation wing has been added to Outpost Delta. Addendum 270E. Data processor 271 has been discontinued. All attempts to electronically resolve portions of SCP-271 have thus far failed. Note by Dr. As of late, concerns have risen regarding the psychological states of personnel working on SCP-270. What I'm talking about, of course, are the natural issues that arise when you have a situation like this. Namely, putting a bunch of highly intelligent, motivated, tenacious people together and ordering them to solve a puzzle that may or may not have a solution, and telling them that lives may depend upon their success or failure. Recently, Dr. by some superhuman effort, cracked several minutes worth of cipher that had been discarded by communal agreement as a dud, and data expunged, resulting in the aversion of an end-of-the-world scenario. This has not been beneficial for the mental states of many personnel, as every dud they discard may contain information regarding an equally disastrous event. Since then, there have been rapidly emerging paranoia and/or obsession-related disorders. Some personnel are beginning to insist that the most trivial details of the cipher contain important messages. Others have not slept or eaten in days in their pursuits, and still others have suffered from psychotic breakdowns. Outpost Delta has since been supplied with more personnel in an attempt to spread the workload more thinly. However, the effects of having a few days of diligent work crumble into a dud, repeatedly, have proven to be an absolute disaster for morale and, at times, mental stability. Currently, we only have enough staff to decode roughly 1% of the cipher. So far, reassigning personnel after a prolonged stay at Outpost Delta, applying Class A amnestics, and returning them to work on 271 at the end of a several-month period of low-pressure jobs has worked fairly well as a short-term solution. This, however, requires a rather large number of personnel to be continually circulating in and out of Outpost Delta to maintain the minimum amount of staff required to decode the greater portion of what comes out of SCP-270. In addition, Long-term circulation throughout Post-Delta has been shown to ingrain certain paranoid and obsessive mental behaviors that Class A amnestics don't wipe clean. I request for this matter to be discussed more in depth sometime in the near future. Dr. Lesson complete. If you missed the previous orientation, go watch SCP-269, Dialysis Bracelet, right now. Or, for the complete course, watch this playlist.